All right, just made it to Zaleski State Forest. Here's the Hope Furnace. Pretty cool stuff. It's probably about 55 degrees. It's 10:45. About to start hiking the trail. It'll be a good day. Let's do it.
All right, first trailhead right here. Zaleski State Forest Backpacking Trail, Old Hollow Trail. Goodbye civilization for a while. See you on the other side.
So I've hiked about 0.6 miles so far. So not very much. It's only been like 25 minutes. But I'm still pretty close to the road. I'm waiting for it to start getting back in the backcountry. Get away from all the civilization. Yeah, feeling good. Ready to roll. So usually they have at the trailhead they have a water fountain. You fill up on some water. I'm only carrying about, I don't know, probably a liter and a half. I was kind of counting on that to be there, but I just have to make do. Gotta keep an open mind out here. Probably should have checked beforehand. Bad planning on my part, but they usually have water at the camping grounds and little spigots, and I'm not sure if those are running, if that water fountain's not running, but we'll see. I have a water filter, so yeah. We'll see. Shout out to the Yuck Boys. Ultra Ultimate 2K16. Yuck! Shout out to Dean. We were seeing this baby last time you were here. Starting to heat up a little. It's because of the hike. I don't think it's actually gotten very much warmer. But yeah, I got a pretty heavy pack weight. Yeah. I have a 32 degree sleeping bag. It's supposed to get down to 28. Remember, 32 degrees is survivability rating. So I brought plenty of layers. So I should be good.
They call me by a number, not a name, Lord. Gotta do my time. Gotta do my time. With an aching heart and a worried mind.
Walking on Zaleski Trail. I'm walking on Zaleski Trail. You hear that? Me either. It's really quiet out here. Well, I think I hear a woodpecker in a plane, but still, it's pretty quiet. I'm walking on Zaleski Trail. I'm walking on Zaleski Trail. Yeah. So it's about 12:47 a.m. Obviously, I made it to the first campsite, but I'm gonna hike through to the next one because this one's pretty close. It's only been like maybe 2.5. Here's the water, and it does work, so it's good. It's definitely good. I've seen a lot of people out Probably because it's Veterans Day weekend. But yeah, it's been a nice hike so far. Yeah, just keep going. Just past campfire one. There's Sujo hanging out there. Didn't talk to him, but seemed pretty. Didn't really look around too much, but it seemed like pretty open area. Kind of far from the water. I think the next campsite, the water is right there, next to like the closest camping spot, so as well as the latrine. So didn't seem like a bad place to camp. But I'm going
onward.
So I kind of saw a ridge line, and I decided to hike up, see if there was a good view, the loft trail. This is what I found. You see that? It's pretty incredible. Good stuff. Loving this trail. It is so flat. I think for a while I'll be following a ridge line, and then probably go down for a while. I know there's a marshy area up ahead, which is one of my favorite parts of this whole place. It's really pretty. Getting pretty hungry. Gonna stop for lunch soon. Pretty sweet overlook somewhere up ahead. So it's the next step. Spot. About to eat some peanut butter and jelly sandwich. That'd be good. It's a pretty steep drop right there. Amazing view. So out there, actually, where my finger is, looks like there's some train tracks. It's either train tracks or a Moondle Hope Road. But as I go down the trail more, that train track should loop and get closer to the trail. So I actually might be able to hike on it for a few seconds or just see it. From the trail, at least, especially in the fall, with all these leaves down. Yeah, heck of a view. One of my favorite spots on the trail, for sure. So I just got to point F on the trail, and what I was saying about the, it was either the railroad or the road, I was farther on the trail than I thought. Actually, that was the railroad, and it says on my trail guide, located on the next hilltop from this overlook is a section of railroad track that is claimed to be haunted by a brakeman known as the Moonville Ghost. He was killed while He was supposedly drunk and trying to stop a train near the Moonville Tunnel by waving his lantern. He's buried in the Moonville graveyard, but reportedly he can still be seen waving his lantern trying to stop the train. That's pretty cool. Soonish, I think I'll be able to actually see the train track, because I can actually see a creek down there. So that'll be cool.
So I'm now at the bottom of a ridge. Kind of lollygagging. Kind of like a little under 4 hours of sunlight left. Like way less than 3 miles probably. Closer to 2 miles, still camp. So I don't know. Just kind of chilling. Probably once I get to the marshy area, which is not too far if I remember right, probably hang out there for a short bit. See what's going on. Yeah. My real goal is to get to camp, get some firewood, and get a fire going before it gets dark. Probably hit the hay early. Yeah. Sounds good.
Hey, what are you doing?
Here we go. I think I see train tracks across there. That's pretty cool. Another one of my favorite spots.
Beside her, I am the better man. When I look to leave her, I always stagger back again. Once I built an ivory tower so I could worship from above. When I climbed down to be set free, she took me in again. There's a big hot sun on the big people in the big hard world. When she comes to greet me, she is mercy at my feet. Yeah, when I see you.
So supposedly this small donut shaped ring was built by the Native Americans of the Adena group and was used for ceremonies. It's pretty cool.
It was a young man named Robert Andrew Brown, who fought for his country and never made it home. But for every dream that's shattered, another one comes true. This car was once a dream of mine, now it belongs to you. And though I wouldn't be here if he hadn't checked along, you'll always be riding
with private
alone.
Absolutely. Positive little bootly. Beautiful. Most. Oh, it's perfect outside. Breeze going, but when it gets cold tonight, the breeze should stop. That's good. Oh, this trail's pretty flat. Oh, I see people up ahead. That must. They actually might be getting water at the next campsite, so looks like I'm almost there. It's about 3 o'clock now. Hiked for about 4 hours, so I'm gonna go set up camp.
Circles that grow and they swallow people.
say goodnight to wives they'll never know. And a mind full of questions and a teacher in my soul. And so it goes. Don't come closer or I'll have to go. Holding me like gravity are places that pull. If ever there was someone to keep me at home,
pretty cold. Actually, two guys came in and they shared their camp, or we shared the camp together, and they're really nice dudes. Helped get a firewood, which was good. But yeah, I think it's time to invest in some warmer gear. I got down to 26 this morning and my toes were numb like all night, but it was still a good night. Now, heading off to the next camp, about 6.8 miles to go today. It's about six and a half yesterday, so time to hit the trail. Another awesome day of hiking. I do regret not recording last night. Hanging out with those dudes, because that was cool. Something I did not expect at all, which is probably one of the greatest things about backpacking, is the things that you don't expect to happen tend to be the greatest and most memorable. You can plan all you want for trips, but in the end, it'll never go exactly the way you plan. So you just gotta be open to things not going the way you want. But it's a good night. I've been hiking long. Pretty easy trail so far. Seen a lot of people today. So we're gonna keep pushing on. Let's do it. Walking on a really well-developed trail, probably an old road, and I completely missed a turn on the trail. So I walked for a little while until I hit a road. I'm like, I gotta turn around. So I'm back on yellow, or orange trail. Just rolled up to my lunch spot, and it actually looks way different than last time. This log, it's where Dean lost his wallet. I just ate a ton of mac and cheese. It was so good. And now I'm laying down, chilling for a few minutes. So tonight I'm gonna try a few things to keep warm. I'm gonna drink something warm, possibly eat something warm, heat up water and put it in a water bottle, and then put it in my sleeping bag, and also I think that's it. Do it. So I made it to camp. I actually camped here last time in campsite 3.
Got some firewood ready.
Definitely need more though for the rest of the night. Probably going to put up my tent next, and then I'm going to start this fire. Really want to save the fire for when it's actually cold. So, baby, we have fire. I'm going to make some salmon and ramen for dinner. We have plenty of firewood for the night and the morning.
When you left this town with your windows down and the wilderness inside, let the exits pass, all the tar and glass, till the road and skyline. The strangers in this town, they raise you up just to cut you down. Oh, Angela, it's a long time coming. And your Volvo lights lit up green and white with the city's on.
So it's about 6 o'clock right now. Got my fire going. Just reading my book, Into the Wild. About to have some trail mix. It's pretty quiet out here. I can hear another group. Probably over 100 yards away, but you're pretty quiet. It's pretty quiet out here. It's nice. It's awesome. And the moon is pretty bright too. Also, actually, it might be full. But tonight is the peak of the Northern Taurids meteor shower, so maybe I'll see some meteors tonight. I don't know. But I'll keep an eye out.
Just to cut you down, oh Angela, it's a long time coming. Oh Angela, spent your whole life running away. Holy land.
So it's about 8 o'clock now, and it's about 32 degrees outside. I got my fire here. She's still burning. So I'm really not cold at all. Yeah, I'm definitely going to switch into, change into my sweatpants, put on some more pairs of socks. I'm gonna go get water before I go to bed. So then I'm like walking and active and the body, get the blood pumping. So hopefully I'm not as cold tonight, even though it is getting colder sooner on than last night. But right now, full moon, it's really bright out. I can see pretty well. Heard a lot of coyotes howling tonight. Don't sound too far actually, but I'm not worried. Yeah, last night it was pretty bright too, and at about I want to say 4 o'clock, I went up to use the bathroom, and it was really dark as the moon went away, and I could see all the lights really well, or the stars really well. So that was really cool to see. Woo! It is good to be out here. Just walked about probably a quarter mile back to the water. It's about 10:30, and with all the leaves it was pretty loud, and I had to walk by all the people in
no one was awake. So I'm sure some people were either nervous or annoyed. I was pretty nervous. It's not the easiest thing to walk through the woods by yourself at night, so. But got me some water. Gonna heat some up, put it back in the water bottle. Have a nice warm water bottle next to me. I'm pretty much ready for bed. Other than that, I'm hoping to stay warm tonight.
Alright, I'm all in bed. I'm pretty warm right now, so I'm pretty excited about that. So we'll see how the night goes. It's about 11 now, so I'm planning to get up at 6:30, so see you then.
Good morning. It's now 6:45, and it's 22 degrees. Got my fire going. Oh my gosh. I was a lot warmer last night, but it was still pretty cold. So, but it was an improvement. So that's good.
Be golden, the way that you left me is alright. It's alright if I argue the point there.
Currently 9:15, and I'm hiking out of here. Last night went way better, way warmer than the night before. I think I just, because I went to bed early, or went to bed warmer than I did the first night. Still pretty cold, I think it's about 30 degrees right now. Not many people on the trail yet. But, kind of sad to leave. It'll be a good day. Enjoy it while I'm here.
You shake my nerves and you rattle my brain. Your kind of love drives a man insane. You broke my will, but what a thrill. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. I left your love and thought it was funny. You came along and you moved me, honey. I changed my mind, this love is fine. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. Tell the world that you're mine, mine, mine. I chew my nails and I twiddle my thumbs. I'm real nervous, but it sure is fun. Ooh, baby, you're driving me crazy. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire.
What'd you say to her? What'd you say to her, man?
Yeah, I said, hey, will you go out with me?
What'd she say?
She said no, man.
Why?
Well, she just didn't think I was a fun guy.
Kentucky. high was born and prayed.
Over this hill here is the parking lot. Mama, we made it.
Ooh-wee. We're back, baby. Lost plan around me. Whatever.
In trouble, where's your hair on earth I find?